Football is a 20th century technological struggle.
And what I seen was this whole raft of people a-setting on these two banks and looking at one another across this pretty little green cow pasture.
Football has hitting, clipping, spearing, blocking, punting, late hitting, unnecessary roughness, and personal fouls.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to season 14, that's 14, of Stanley County Monday Night Football. I'm Charles Churchill for the Stanley News and Press, alongside my friend Mr. Brian Carter of Carter Video Services. That's him. We are here tonight to start season 14. It doesn't seem like one of us is getting old, Brian. I don't know which one it is, of Monday Night Football. We are here once again, and we've kicked this off for several seasons with this game, South Stanley at West Stanley. This one's got a lot of interesting subtext and subplots as well. We see West Stanley warming up behind us right now. West Stanley comes into tonight's game having lost 8 games in a row. Their last win was a forfeit to Albemarle, but they have a new coach this year in Eric Mormon. He was an assistant last year with the team, and they return 1,000-yard rusher junior Malik Jackson. That's number 33 that just took the handoff, I believe you just saw. And number 8 is going to be very important too, right there in the very same shot. And number 9, Connor Edwards. Connor Edwards is the quarterback of this defense. Or excuse me, number 8 is Connor Edwards. Connor is, like I say, he's the outside linebacker. He is the heart and soul of this defense, and he really helps push the pace for this defense. And we see also number 12, Christian Boone, warming up. He is one of two starting quarterbacks, along with number 4, as you see right there, Taylen Rao. We don't know yet who is going to be starting tonight for West Stanley. Well, this is a battle of two brand new head coaches, and on the South Stanley side, of course, Brad Froge is the new head coach for the Rebel Bulls. He was a coach for 4 seasons with the team under head coach Tasker Fleming, and 1 year, of course, under Luke Little. And now he lost a lot of players to graduation, including star standout quarterback Luke Burris. Of course, Luke was the leading passer last year in Stanley County. And they've gone to number 19, Maxton Horton will be their quarterback now. So a lot of changes on that side of the ball. Some graduations, some people transferred to other schools and things like that. South will dress 24 people tonight. West Stanley has a few more than that, so it's going to be an interesting matchup in that instance. We'll be back with our head coaches on Stanley County Monday Night Football. Here we go. We're back here on the pregame show on Stanley County Monday Night Football with new South Stanley head coach Brad Froge. Coach, let's talk a little bit just about this team in the preseason. I know that you've talked about, you know, trying to bring your own spin to the team, your own feelings, your own, you know, goals that you want for this team. Talk a little bit about the preparations this offseason.
I think the majority of the preparations were just focused on conditioning, focused on the weight room, going back into the weight room and really getting in shape. We're a young team, so being a young team, we really wanted to hammer home our ideas. We felt like we could really put our mold into this, really put our spin on these kids, and really put, again, the influence on conditioning, getting in shape. We're low on numbers on the varsity level. Being low, got to be in shape, got to be able to play.
We talked a little bit, a couple of times, obviously, about, you know, nerves coming in for your first game, but being on the road maybe just a little bit easier. But, Coach, talk a little bit just about what your expectations are, you know, coming into this.
Yeah, I mean, definitely a little bit nervous. If I said I wasn't nervous, I'd be lying. I mean, I think everybody nervous, and I told somebody earlier, you know, really I think it's nerves, it's first game nerves. Mm-hmm. I really feel like we're prepared. I feel like we're there, not 100% there, and I don't expect us to be 100% of where we want to be at this time. You know, if we were where we want to be at the end of the season, I'd say we're in trouble. You know, really what I expect out of this game is, let's figure out what we can and can't do for the rest of the season. Let's compete in this game. Let's, again, get after it, hit somebody other than our own selves, and you know, hopefully get win number 1 under our belt.
How do you feel like South Stanley matches up with West?
I actually think we match up pretty well this year. I know we spoke earlier in the week about last year. I felt like they were more physical than us. Mm-hmm. And I think this year, again, putting that emphasis on the weight room, putting that emphasis on conditioning, I think we match up a lot better there than what we did a year ago. I also think that we may even be a little bit more athletic than them this year. South typically has a little bit more athletes. West typically has some of your bigger football players. So it's kind of a contrast in styles when this year we're going to match up the same way. We're going to try to be a bit more of a power team and not try to just beat everybody to the edge. So it should be a good matchup.
Coach, thanks you very much for your time. Best of luck tonight.
Yes, sir. Thank you.
We'll be back with West Stanley head coach Eric Moorman. Back here on the pregame show on Stanley County Monday Night Football with West Stanley head coach Eric Moorman. Coach, tell us a little, talk a little bit about this team preparations in the offseason. You had a lot of kids come out, 70 kids, and that has to be very encouraging for you to get those kids and like the kids from the basketball team as well.
Yes, sir. Actually, you know, right now we had 72 kids out. These guys have been working hard all summer. The great thing about it, I have worked well with Coach Thompson, the basketball coach, and he got a lot of our guys out. As I talked to Mr. Curcio about early in the year, we wanted to have a JV team and for development, and those guys have been doing a great job. We had great numbers, and we're very excited about that, Mr. Curcio.
Talk a little bit about this matchup with South Stanley. Obviously, both teams going to want to be able to establish a ground game, but it's West Stanley that brings in, you know, a talented 1,000-yard rushing like Malik Jackson.
Malik Jackson is an awesome running back. He's been working very hard this summer. All preseason, he's not only wanting to learn his position, but he wants to learn the entire scheme. And we're very excited. I know he's very excited to get started here tonight.
And you have really two great talented quarterbacks with Christian Boone and Taylen Rao.
Yes, Christian Boone has a big arm. He will put the ball down the field. We're going to be very aggressive with Christian when he's out there. We'll throw a lot of play action. With Taylen, he also can put the ball down the field, but he brings a different dimension. He can run a little bit, and so we're going to see a lot of both. We're very excited about seeing both of these guys.
What are the keys to a victory tonight for West Stanley?
Like I talked to all of my guys about, being disciplined. That's the key, being disciplined on defense and offense. Offensively, I talked to them about protecting the football. Defense, we want to cause a lot of turnovers. We want to make sure that we're wrapping up, running to the football. Just like I told, we're coming out to compete. We just want to make sure we're having fun. It's always football, so that's the key.
Coach, thank you very much for your time. Best of luck tonight.
Yes, sir. Thank you.
South Stanley, West Stanley. Doesn't get any better to kick off season 14. That time I got it right. Of Stanley County Monday Night Football. Here we go. Once again, good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to Stanley County Monday Night Football. Charles Curcio from the Stanley News and Press, alongside Brian Carter of Carter Video Services. Mr. Carter, how are you tonight? Say something.
Oh, I'm doing great tonight, Charles. Great to be back here. It seems like I can't believe we're back here again.
It's faster every year. It means one of us is getting older, and it's you.
Yeah. You're getting up there too, Charles.
Hey, this has been our 14th season of bringing you Stanley County Monday Night Football. We got another great matchup here to start with West Stanley here in Red Cross hosting South Stanley. You know, we were talking a little earlier in the pregame about the numbers, and obviously South Stanley is dressing about 24, 25 kids tonight. West Stanley, much more than that, up in the 30 range. That's going to be a factor, I think, later in this game. Just to see South Stanley's, one of their goals in tonight's game, Brian, has to be just to stay fresh.
Oh, yeah. I mean, they're going to play both sides, you know, offense and defense playing both sides of the ball, and that's going to wear you out after a while. And West Stanley's definitely, you can see the size difference. But we'll see if that takes effect tonight.
West Stanley won the toss. They will receive. South Stanley will be moving left to right, choosing to defend the goal nearest the field house.
We'll be kicking off to the home West Stanley coach to see if you get this season.
So West will start out on offense. We talked. I talked in the newspaper this week in our preview that West Stanley really hadn't chosen a starting quarterback, and they still are kind of mulling it over. I know tonight they're going to go with number 12, Christian Boone. We saw Christian last year in a terrific game. I'm trying to remember. I believe it was the second game of the season where he threw very well before he was injured. But Taylen Rao gives them another really good quarterback as well. It's just sort of a different one. Here come the South Stanley Rowdy Rebel Bulls. A first-year head coach, Brad Froge, of course, he's been there, as we said earlier, four seasons with the Rebel Bulls.
And here they come, folks, on your feet.
And now here come the West Stanley Colts.
West Stanley Colts!
That was Nate Taylor leading the charge about 10 yards in front of everyone else.
Yeah,
you're going to see, I'll tell you though, Brian, I think one of the things I'm interested to see early in this game is some of the basketball players that we talked about that are now on West Stanley's team, as in Nate Taylor, who just led the charge. Number five, Brandon Sturdivant, he's 6'3". He's a great target for them, a wide receiver. And Taylen Rao as the quarterback. They have gotten more athletes just in getting just those three guys, let alone some of the other players that they've gotten back to West Stanley, you know, back to playing varsity football for the Colts. We apologize for the, I don't know what that sound was exactly. That might have been your microphone. We're going to, I'm going to turn off your mic for just a second, and we may have to take some time in a few minutes and trying to figure out what's wrong with Meester Carter's microphone. He may be a bad battery. So looks like it's going to be a little Vin Scully action. You know, Vin Scully doesn't need a color commentator, so it looks like I'm on my own as well for the foreseeable future until we can figure out what's going on with your particular microphone. Kicking off for South Stanley is number three, Eli Blake. So here we go, season 14 of Stanley County Monday Night Football. Let's roll. Very short end over end kick going to be taken by Sturdivant at the 32. He's trying to find some room. He's just going to lean forward to the 35.
Maybe about 35-yard line, taken out of the air, number five, Brandon Sturdivant.
So Sturdivant with kind of a jump ball there, trying to get control of that kickoff. Just straight up in the air. And West Stanley will set up shop at the 35, first and 10. Again, starting quarterback tonight is the junior, number 12, Christian Boone. Behind him is the back, number 33, Malik Jackson. Had one extra player in the lineup. Looked like Jaquan Ingram now comes out of the lineup. And it's going to be Malik trying to make a move. Cuts a little bit to the right side. It's going to be stopped by Michael Pressler after maybe a yard. He'll bring up second and nine. Second down and nine. We just started here at West Stanley High School. That time going under center. Instead of the shotgun or the pistol formation, they'll go under center once again from the I formation, second and nine. Jackson again this time, trying to find some room to the outside, and he gets wrapped up by number seven, Noah Carpenter.
And not much gain either again that time, and it's going to bring up third down.
Michael Butler in on that stop. No gain on the play.
Also, I believe Michael Butler in on the tackle. So we'll give him another yard. It'll bring up third down and 8. Four wide receivers this time. Now Boone will operate from the shotgun. There, linebackers are going to have to try to get out for South and try to cover that. Now looking over the middle. Oh, it's knocked away. Is it a fumble or is it? It's a live ball. South has it. South has it at the 29. They're going to rule that knocked away as a fumble. And oh, they're going to rule it an incomplete pass. Oh, for a second there, I thought South Stanley had a turnover. Brian Schenkel dry certainly fell on the football like he thought he had knocked it loose. So I have to say that's an incomplete pass that is quite a break for West Stanley. Logan Green will punt the football away, and Z Bailey is standing at about the Rebel Bowl 25. We saw Green booming some missiles over our heads in the pregame. So we know he's got a great leg, and now we've got, looks like a late sub coming in, Jaquan Ingram. There's a penalty flag sitting down. I wonder if it's maybe an illegal substitution. No, it's going to be a timeout. West Stanley will take a timeout. So we'll take one as well. 10:18 left here in the opening quarter. No score. Back on Stanley County Monday Night Football, this punt from Green goes off the side of his foot. A penalty marker comes in very late at around the 42. Let's see what that penalty marker is. Not exactly sure what this call is. Everybody just sort of stood away from the football, so really impossible to tell you what the call is. Let's see, because I really didn't see anything. Dead ball, personal foul against West Stanley. So that's going to go after. That was after the play. So South's going to get their first possession in really good territory. So the ball is resting now at the West 42, which means that the actual call was at the 47. I did not see what the call was, but South Stanley now first and 10 from the Colt 42. Maxton Horton is the starting quarterback. He'll give to number one straight up the middle. That's Juwan Morris. Oh, and Morris may have fumbled the football. They're going to rule it down by contact. A gain of about 2. It'll bring up second down and about 7, maybe 8. Again, we apologize for our audio difficulties. Mr. Carter is really not usually this quiet. We'll have to rig you up another microphone. I believe we have a backup mic for these situations. Second down and 8 now. South running sort of a pistol offense, it looks like. Three in the backfield with a H-back. Horton will sweep it this time. And Morris looked like he was trying to go to the outside. There was nothing there. So he cut it back a little bit. And he got a couple more yards. And it brings up third down and about 6, maybe 7. Maxton Horton, of course, a member of South Stanley's baseball team. This past June, it went to the state finals. Actually, there are a few. The kicker, Eli Blake, is another member of that team. Now, over the, looking for number 15. I think that was Schenkel Dry. The pass is incomplete, and it'll bring up fourth down. So both teams have had one incompletion, Sark, so far, and now it looks like they're going to go for it on fourth down and 7. Or maybe a long 6. Working without a huddle as well. Colts have 5, 6, 7, 8 up to try to stop them. There's single coverage on the near side. Now looking to the outside, incomplete. Intended for number 9, Tavian McKinney, and it's going to be incomplete, and Wes Stanley will take over. Number 58 knocked it down. I believe that's Adam Slaughter, junior D lineman for Wes Stanley. So we change possession with 8 minutes and 46 seconds left, opening quarter. Both teams have had one possession, and neither team has had a first down yet. Three wide receivers this time, 2 to the near side on 1st and 10 for the Colts from the 38. Going to swing it this way, complete to Rowe. Rowe, he gets to the 45, 50, and out of bounds at about the 47, and that's the first down of the game. And they're going to mark it at the 45. So 1st and 10, and Wes Stanley quickly to the line. A 17-yard gain and a first down now. Looking the other way, same play, other direction, and this time Rowe falls down, and he got about a yard. So it'll bring up 2nd down. Clock running now, just a little over 8 minutes. No score, Wes Stanley and South Stanley. Again, 3 wide receivers, and Rowe is in the slot position this time with Justin Balcom down on the near side here. It's going to be Malik Jackson. He puts his head down, hits the pile hard. Number 67 made the stop is Michael Butler. So really, no gain, maybe just a yard gain. We'll give him a yard progress. It brings up 3rd down and 8. And neither team has had an easy 3rd down to convert so far in this game. Boone looking to throw again. Now he'll go towards the corner for Bogum. He's got it. Oh, he hits a hard shot, but hangs on to it at the 20. What a great catch. Bakum just got really hit hard, but he hung on to the football. And that's the 2nd first down of the game for Wes Stanley, and they'll mark the ball at the 19, a 20-yard gain. So when he said that, when Coach said that they would throw the ball downfield, that's exactly what they've done so far. Now going to the far side, complete to number 13, that's Nate Taylor. Taylor trying to make some moves, and he does. He's still on his feet. 5, and he is in. Touchdown, Wes Stanley Colts. What a great play by Nate Taylor. Just a little swing pass to the far side of the field, and he just made a few moves, made a few players miss, and Wes Stanley is on the board. And that's a very happy head coach right there, is with a big smile on his face after that play. A 19-yard touchdown. Green for the extra point. They only have 10 players out there. And there's no football either. There's no football. I don't know. I don't know how they could. I don't even know. This is interesting. I want to see how this plays out. They're going to get a penalty. Now, it's delay of game. There's exactly 7 minutes left. Well, there's a football there, but for a second, I didn't see the football either. You're right. So a little longer extra point this time. Kick is up. And the kick is good. 7 minutes left, opening quarter. West Stanley 7, South Stanley nothing. We'll be back on Stanley County Monday Night Football. We're back on Stanley County Monday Night Football. 7-0 in favor of the Colts. Juwan, oh, he fumbles the football, and it goes right into the hands of Zenario Bailey, who will take it to the 20-yard line. An odd play there. And I would like to take a very quick opportunity to welcome back to the broadcast Mr. Brian Carter.
I just had to take a break for a little while, you know, get a little hot.
And tired already, okay. That's what happens when you're old, huh?
Who are you calling old?
You!
Well, it's like West Stanley's off to a good start.
Certainly are. First and 10 now from the 20. Horton's going to roll. He's running out of room already, and he will go down in the arms of number 55, Kyle Pennington.
Yeah, he really didn't have a chance here, Charles.
No, he tried. They tried to get him on a bootleg, and by the time he turned around, they lose 13 yards on the play back to the 7.
And now West has South pinned back pretty deep. How many yards did he lose on that play?
Lost 13, actually 12 yards on the play. It's second down in downtown Locust at this point. Second down at about 22.
Let's see if Thornton can bring him back here.
Gives it to Morris. Morris hits the line hard. Number 42, Zach Washburn with a tackle. Maybe a gain of about 3 or 4 yards. But South Stanley, if they want to stay in this game, they have to avoid sacks like that, especially when we're talking about a 13-yard loss.
Oh, yeah, Horton needs just get out of the pocket and get rid of the ball.
Well, he needs time and space to do that, too. He turned right into a West Stanley player. Now third down and 19. Got a little time this time. Puts it up in the air, and it looks like he and his receiver, number 6, Dallas Starnes, on the wrong page. Starnes went on a post pattern, and he was throwing a flag pattern.
Yeah, definitely not on the same page there.
So they'll bring him another punting situation. This will be the first punt of the night for South Stanley. We'll see how much pressure West Stanley brings. Number 22, Joseph Izaguirre, is going to stand at about the 45, maybe about midfield. Cody Carpenter, the senior, will punt this one away. Nice kick. It's going to take a big south bounce and going to roll away. Izaguirre needs to get away from that ball, and so does... I'll tell you, so does Nate Taylor. He was about 6 centimeters away from making that a live football.
You got to be careful when you surround that ball. If you touch it, it's low.
So it rolls dead at the South 49. A 30-yard punt. Clock stopped now with 5 minutes and 6 seconds left in the opening quarter. West Stanley leads 7-0, and they have good field position on this drive, their third drive of the game so far. Balcom and Rowe come to the near side of the... It looks like Sturdivant on the far side. Now it's going to be Jackson. Jackson's got some room at the middle. 45-30, 25, one move. He is gone. See you later. Touchdown, West Stanley Colts.
Mr. Malik Jackson. That's why he's...
And that's why when you have a running back like that, that's what can happen.
That was a sight to see. He shot out of there like a bullet.
Well, and he got blocks, you know. His first few runs, you know, he was having to try to really didn't have much room to run. South Stanley was doing a good job of kind of keeping him penned in. This time, he just got through the line so fast. He was in the secondary before they knew what happened. Now Green, oh, the snap's a little low. Kick is up. That kick is good. 4:55 left to go in the first quarter. West Stanley 14, South Stanley nothing. We'll be back on Stanley County Monday Night Football. We're back on Stanley County Monday Night Football. West Stanley with a strong first quarter after a tentative first drive. They have scored on their last two drives and now lead 14 to nothing. Green with a long end-over-end kick. It's going to put Morris back into the end zone, and that's an automatic touchback.
I tell you, Green, when we were seeing him in practicing earlier, I mean, he's got a leg on him.
He's got a booming leg, absolutely. And you can't really, you know, we've seen so many good kickers over the years. I think of the Tyler Lewis's.
Oh, yeah. You know, forget Tyler.
You just can't understand what an advantage, you know, that really gives you when you have to when you force teams to go 80 yards every single time. That is an important skill to have, an important depth of your team.
Well, I can't remember when the last elite kicker and in the county was besides Tyler back at that time.
This time is Juwan Morris, and a good gain for South Stanley. Gets some good lead blocking that time. He gets about six, that brings up second down and four. And now Morris looks like he's hobbling off the sideline. Do you see that, Brian? At about the 35, there he is. Looks like he
looks a little gimpy.
May have a cramp there.
Yeah, it looks like
Tavian McKinney comes in and will replace him at that halfback position.
Yeah, it looks like a cramp in his calf.
Second and four now. Horton under center fakes the snap, now gives to the up back. Number 31, that's Michael Pressler. And Pressler may be a couple of yards. South Stanley is playing very up-tempo at this point with a no-huddle offense. A no-huddle is a relative term. Obviously, they all have the wristbands and are getting the plays that way. But they're not allowing West Stanley to get a lot of subs in. And that may be obviously my design. McKinney this time just stopped immediately.
And thrown for a loss.
That's Jaquan Ingram. And I think it was 55 Kyle Pennington as well. A loss of three. Brings up fourth down and five. And
yeah, we have to punt this one away.
Another punting situation, yes. Izaguirre standing at about the 40 for West. So far, West defense has not given South a lot of room to operate. A short punt this time takes another big South Stanley bounce and is going to roll down to about the 41-yard line and go out of bounds. So once again, not terrible field position. And with 2 minutes and 43 seconds left.
They've really put Carpenter to work tonight.
Certainly have, and they've certainly, after Malik had gains of about 2, 3, and 4, he got 49 of the 52 yards he has on four carries right now on that 49-yard touchdown run that gave West a 14-0 lead.
He could be in for a stellar game.
And the Colts looking for more now. Four wide receivers this time, and now a new quarterback. Taylen Rowe is now in at quarterback.
We were wondering if they were going to switch him up.
And indeed they are. Now Rowe will keep it. Trying to find some room to the outside. Gets past McKinney. Still on his feet and finally gets tackled from behind by Yarborough at the 44. A gain of about three. You know, there are a lot of teams that have tried, over the years, they've tried to do that two-quarterback system.
We're kind of wondering, it's like, if they were going to go with just a starter or go with a two-quarterback tandem.
Well, sometimes, a lot of coaches like to try to change the tempo. And I think that's what they're trying to do here. Now trips again, practically shoulder to shoulder here on the bottom of the screen. On second down and seven. Going to throw this way. It's complete to Balcom. He's got blockers in front of him. Gets out of one tackle, and McKinney will get him. It's going to be very close to a first down. It may be a measurement. Oh, they gave him actually. Wow, that's a really good spot. Yeah, that's a good spot. I thought he was a couple of yards short of that, Brian, but I thought he was right at the stick. But they're going to mark it at the south 47, and that's good enough for a first down. Two in the backfield this time. Rao will keep it. Oh, and he gets hit hard right at the line of scrimmage.
Ooh. No gain there.
Jake Green, I think it was, the senior. Good Lord, what a hit.
Oh, and Rose getting up pretty slow. Yeah, he's coming out.
No gain on the play. Brings up second down and 10.
He got shaken up pretty good.
Just looking at the sidelines, I don't think he's hurt. I think he's just a little upset. He's just kind of walking it off right now.
Just walk it off. Yeah, we got under a minute to go, 50 seconds.
Three wide receivers again on second down and nine now from the 40. Second down, maybe nine and a half. They'll give to Jackson. Jackson's got a blocker in front of him. Sal Stanley pursuing well to the sideline. Oh, did he take a really hit hard by number 7 and 17. Kobe Morton was right on top of him. Noah Carpenter came up from behind and just
Malik's hobbling a little bit.
Hit
there,
him hard. Is he?
Yes. Yeah, he might have to come out.
Only a gain of maybe, they're going to give him 2 yards.
I think he's trying to stick it
which
out.
Which is a little charitable, I thought, on that one. But it'll bring up third down on a long eight. And this will probably be the final play of the first quarter. Yeah, they're not going to try to run another play, I don't believe.
Yeah, that's it.
So we'll be back with the second quarter. Right now, after one quarter of play, it's West Stanley 14, South Stanley nothing. On Stanley County, Monday Night Football. We're back on Stanley County Monday Night Football for the second quarter. Charles Kersey of the Stanley News and Press, Brian Carter of Carter Video Services, and
how you doing?
A very effective first quarter. Now third down and 8 for Boone. Looking over the middle, it's tipped. Oh, tip drill and incomplete. And oh, Sturdivant was chugging, just trying to get to that football.
Great opportunity for South.
That was absolutely a free ball up in the air, but just nobody home. And it's going to bring up fourth down.
South Stanley's going to have to take advantage of those situations, Charles.
Absolutely. They're going to have to try to create some offense.
Get an opportunity like that, you need to take advantage of it.
Green now to punt the football, and Zenario Bailey standing at about the 15-yard line. Play clock running a little short. Does get it off. Beautiful spiraling punt. Nobody's going to have a chance at this one, and that's just going to roll sideways inside the 10, down around the 7. And that's
beautiful,
the advantage
beautiful.
That a punter can give you. What a beautiful punt.
I'll tell you, you know, during warm-ups, I was really impressed with them. When you down there on the field and you see it, you know, close up, I was very impressed.
You know, I was looking through an old, the first football preview I ever did for the Stanley News and Press. I did a column about it in this year's football preview out on newsstands, and I was
today,
and I was it was interesting. I remember one of the largest kickers I ever saw in my life played for West Stanley. That story in a minute. First and 10. Now the snaps to the up man. And a good hold this time by number 31.
Yeah, he did. He had a hold.
Hustler had a great, great lane to run through. A gain of about 7. It brings up 2nd and 3. South still looking for their first down of the game. Give a lot of credit. I believe it was 65, Thomas Yarborough, that helped lead that charge. Oh, now fumbled the football. Oh, it's still loose. I think South got it back, but I'm not sure. It was at somebody's feet.
The officials on top of him trying to get the ball out. They're fighting over it.
Third down, so the South does recover. Well, honestly, I don't think that I don't think that 31 Pressler ever had the football, particularly. No gain on the play, though. And we'll bring up third down now at about 3. Horton on a great play action. Got a man wide open, incomplete. Oh!
Great.
Just Tavian McKinney was open. He was wide open. Horton did a wonderful job of getting free, but just couldn't connect. And it's another punting situation.
Deepen.
It was a good play call too. They tried that one time before, and instead, in that first time, if you remember, Brian, Horton turned right into a gray jersey. But this time, he had all day to throw.
Oh, yeah, plenty of room.
They won't rush this one again, and the punt's away. It's a low end-over-end kick. It's kind of a shorter kick this time. Going to roll out of bounds at the 38, only about a 24-yard net gain on that punt.
Well, let's give West Stanley great field position. 10-24 to go in this second quarter.
Certainly does. It puts the ball at the South 37. Listening to the strains of the West Stanley band, doing a great job down there. You know, I'm very glad that when we do the football preview now that we're able to include pictures of the band. We didn't get Albemarle's band. That's my fault. I take blame for that, but I will be get a picture of them into the paper at some point. I like the fact that we try to include everything that comes around.
The cheerleaders and everything.
The cheerleaders, the band, yeah. That's important.
That was a great preview edition, by the way.
Oh, why, thank you. First and 10 now from the Colt 38. Going to give to Jackson. He's got some room to the outside. Got a blocker in front of him. 35, 30. Look at the move. 25, 20. He's going to run out of real estate and go out short at about the 15. But he's well has the first down by plenty.
He made that look so easy. I think he was like half speed.
It was sort of like a Sunday jog. But when he got out to the outside, you could see he runs on the balls of his feet. It's like a dancer when he gets out there. So a 23-yard gain, excuse me, down to the 14. First and 10 now, and the Colts are in the red zone. Boone will throw to the near side. It's complete to Rowe. And Rowe does not get a lot of yardage this time. Great play by, I believe that was 57, Cody Carpenter. I know this sounds like a crazy thing to say, Brian, but I really like the numbers that South has on their jersey because they're very easy to see even without a set of binoculars.
They're going to stare right at you. You can see the numbers very clearly.
They're going to mark about a half a yard loss. So it brings up second down and 11. Clock running, 9:38 left second quarter. Colts leading 14-0, looking for more. Jackson now around the left side. Now he's going to cut back. He's got a lane. He's got one man to beat. Gets a great block in front of him, and he's in. Touchdown, West Stanley Colts. There's a penalty, but there is a penalty marker down. And I don't know that if Sturdivant is the guilty party or not. It is holding. The whole thing's coming back. But I think the hold was somewhere on the line. It wasn't Sturdivant out in front. So it takes 6 points off the board.
and pushes him back 10.
Going to mark the ball at the 25. What, the third or fourth penalty on West Stanley so far? Second down now and 21. Ball outside the red zone. They almost look like they moved a little early this time. Jackson, he's out of real estate immediately, and whoa, is he buried at the 27 and 65 Yarborough once again.
Fine defense of South Stanley stepping up, stopping the lead.
Brings up third down and 23, and what was a touchdown now is third and very long.
And Malik Jackson's coming out of the game for a respite.
Well, this is a passing situation. I think that for certain you're going to see Boone put it in the air.
That's one thing South Stanley wanted to do, is make them get away from the running game and go to the air.
Boone now over the middle, and it's, almost intercepted right through the hands of Maxton Horton. And he had a lot of real estate on his side of the field, too.
Yeah, nice stop for the Rowdy Ridable Bulls.
That's easy for you to say. And it brings up fourth and 23, and this is an interesting situation. They're going to attempt a field goal. They're marking the ball at about the 31, so it's going to be a 41.
He's got the leg
for it, definitely. We have seen him practice. He was hitting 35, 40, 50, 45. Let's see if he's got the leg here for this one.
I'm going to follow this one.
Snap is good. Kick is up. Oh, has it got the distance? It's straight on. Oh, it hit the post. Hit the crossbar, excuse me.
That's a heartbreaker.
Get my hardware right. It hit the crossbar. Just needed a little more.
Right on target. Right on target. 1 yard, a couple of feet would have done it. Well, that's a break for the Bulls.
Definitely. .831 left in the second quarter. South Stanley trailing 14-0, and they needed a stop desperately and got one. But so far, the offense has not been able to move the football. Nice spin move, but he is going the wrong direction. And he gets finished off by none other than Mr. Connor Edwards, number 8.
You lose about 3-4 yards on that one.
Just about. Morris was trying to get free, but there was just nowhere to go. And he loses 5 yards on the play. And it brings up second down and 15. They're going to try to toss sweep, but he tries to cut inside one blocker, trying to get to the outside. Does momentarily, but gets finished off right at the 21. To give him 6 yards, he gets the loss of yards back and then maybe an extra. But it's still a long third and nine. South Stanley talked about in the pregame and talked to me earlier this week about wanting to match West's physicality. Well, defensively, they've done that except for a couple of glaring exceptions. But in the case of the offense, they've just not been able to get – they've had some flashes of good blocking, but have just not been able to get a lot going. Going to go play action this time. He rolls again. He's got time, and he runs out of time, and he gets tripped up at the 10.
Pins him back even deeper with 6:54 to go.
Well, and it'll also be another punting situation on fourth down. It's a loss of 11 yards. And looks like 4:20. When you count those as sacks are rushing losses, right now, South Stanley does not have any yards of offense, period. They have 0 yards of offense, net.
Short punt.
Punt, and this time it takes a West Stanley bounce and stops right at the 30-yard line. Another about 25-yard punt this time. Ball marked at the 33. And with 6:17 left, South avoided trouble on the last possession that they had, that West Stanley, that they gave to West Stanley inside their own territory. At least it started inside their own territory. And once again, going to call on the defense to try to have to make another stop. Four wide receivers this time. I see Logan Wahlberg, the sophomore, is in the slot to the far side of the field. Little play action this time. Looking over the middle, incomplete, and once again, another one tipped up in the air, just waiting for someone to pick off, and nobody can get to it. And it falls incomplete and brings up second down. Neither team huddles. Have you noticed that? They use the armbands and signaling systems and things like that.
I know it's because Coach Froge had the
armband.
Yeah, that's armband on.
Second down this time, he's going to give it to Malik. Malik trying to find some room. Oh, nice move that time. Runs into four defenders, but not after a gain of about six, maybe seven. It's going to bring up a manageable third down.
Takes it, you see how it takes a lot to take it, Malik, down. He's pretty much having his way tonight.
Well, you think of Malik as being one of those elusive backs, and he is. But then he really also is a very physical runner. So he can give you a little of that as well. Three wide receivers this time on third and about four. Going to be Malik straight up the middle. He's got the first down. Big hole across the 20, down around the 18.
You're right. I mean, very physical player. I mean, it took like three bulls to take him down.
That's about the fifth or sixth first down in this game so far for West Stanley. South Stanley has yet to get a first down. Three wide receivers once again. West in the red zone once again. About the third or fourth time this night. Jackson now gets through the defense once again. Still on his feet. 10, 5, and still down. Now down at the 3-yard line.
Yeah, Malik is on fire tonight. Oh, we got a little tussle down there on the field between Malik and one of the Rowdy Bulls.
So a 13-yard gain and a first down, and it's first and goal now. Clock running under 5 minutes. A slow snap this time, and I think we may have a false start against West. And it will be a legal procedure against West. Eight first downs in this game for West Stanley. Only one for South Stanley, excuse me. They do have a first down. But as far as penalties go, that's the fourth penalty of the game against West Stanley. Boone now looking at the near side, got Rowe. Rowe down around the five, man, making the six. Well, they get most of that yardage back.
He's a little slow getting up. He took a shot.
Well, that's about the third time they've run that little, what we call a bubble screen. It's only a gain of 3 yards, and really Talon had to pay the price for that gain. Second and goal now from the six, 4:08 left. Second quarter, Colts up 14-0 and looking for more. Another low snap, they run into each other. And Boone will go down at the five. He'll actually gain a yard. It's not it doesn't go as a sack. And it's now third and goal from the five.
Defense stepping up for South.
Well, in that case, I'm not trying to differ with you, Brian, but you're wrong. I'm just kidding. But when there was just a miscommunication between Boone and Jackson that time. But Boone actually turned it into a positive play. But now a critical play here. And I think West Stanley is going to take some time, and they will take timeout. We will as well. 3:26 left, second quarter. West Stanley 14, South Stanley nothing. We'll be back. We're back on Stanley County Monday Night Football. Critical play here for West Stanley. They lead 14-0, 3:26 left, second quarter. As we pan across the field to the 5-yard line, third and goal. This time it looked like it was a direct snap to Boone. There's a flag down. Boone runs into a wall of white jerseys. And
this could be holding.
And it is holding. And this is an interesting choice here. Because here's the situation.
Tell me the situation, Charles.
I think you have to take the penalty even though you've stopped him. Because 4th and 5 looks he's still not a manageable, you know, is a manageable down. But 3rd and 15 might not be as easy.
Interesting dilemma.
Yeah, I think this is one of those times when you have to. I think you have to send it back. And that's exactly what they're going to do. Ordinarily, you would not do that if it was in the middle of the field. But at that particular position, it's now 3rd and 20. And 3rd and 20 is a little more daunting than 4th and 5, especially when you're at the 5. So a critical mistake there. They were trying to run some sort of direct snap or something. I'm not exactly sure what. It was almost like a misdirection. It had me confused. Now I see Connor Edwards is lined up as sort of an H-back out there. 3rd and goal now from the 20. Boone looking to the near sideline. He's looking for it. Oh, he's got him! End zone! Waiting for a signal. He is down at the 1-foot line. He is just short of the end zone. He fell down just... just short beautiful. Of it, it was Logan Wahlberg.
Beautiful pass.
Wahlberg, it's going to be 4th and goal. Looks like on the 1-foot line.
So with 2:42, okay, fourth and goal. Now that's an absolute go for it. That's absolute, you go for it. I don't think that there's not even a second thought here. Because if you don't get it, then you have South pinned deep with 2.5 minutes left. And 5 will get you 10. They might even try to go under center for this one. That's exactly what they're going to do. And maybe just Boone on a straight sneak. No, it's going to be Jackson. And he easily goes to the outside. Walks in for a touchdown. West Stanley Colts. I think for a second there they thought there was going to be a sneak of some sort. But
yeah, the West Stanley faithful are happy about this.
Finishes off a 4-minute drive. 2:06 left. Green coming out for the extra point. Now waiting for, I think West might have had 10 players out there.
Better be careful to get another delay of game.
And that's what they just did. So there's been a couple of those, two of those on extra points. And not that Green can't kick it even 5 yards further back, but you just don't want to have to give him.
Yeah.
You don't want to have to test. You don't have to give him, make him have to do it.
You know, that point after, you know, that can make a difference in a ball game sometimes.
But that's sort of the things that you sort of work out in these early games. That low kick.
And that is no good at so.
No, he got it. He snuck it over the. No, I was watching it the whole way. He snuck it right over that crossbar. That's good. Wow. So with 2:06 left, second quarter, West Stanley 21, South Stanley nothing. We'll be back on Stanley County Monday Night Football. 2:06 left here in the second quarter. West Stanley comfortably up now, 21-0. Malik Jackson with a 1 yard dive off the right side. Green end over end kick is going to come up just a little short. Oh, Colby Morton got back and took it right out of the hands of number one. Now he's got some room. Oh, and he just runs out of it very quickly at the 18 yard line. Oh,
just shy of the 20. Just got to wonder how much steam the Rowdy Bulls are going to have going into the second half here.
Very true. And
1:59 to go in the half.
And the other problem is they don't have any bench hardly. So most of the guys are playing both ways on the field.
Just very shallow, very shallow.
Gonna go five wide this time. Snap is almost over the head of Horton. He hangs onto it, looking over the middle, and it's caught in the hands of number one, Juwan Morris, and now it's a foot race, and he is gone. See
unbelievable.
You later. Touchdown, South Stanley Rebel Bulls on
tip.
An 80-yard pass. And that's the third tip we've seen in this game that had a chance to make a big difference.
Make a
and
big difference,
that one
yeah.
just did.
And it just did. Wow.
82 yards on the play.
Do you think that's one for the highlight reel?
That is definitely one for the highlight reel.
We'll save that tape. Just what the Rowdy Bulls needed. They'll put the roses back in their cheeks.
Maxton Horton will be the holder, and Eli Blake coming out to for the extra point. 1:43 left at South. Comes away just smelling with roses on that play. Oh, the snap is not good, and it's going to be falling on and incomplete. So that's where we will stand with 1:43 left to go, second quarter. West Stanley 21, South Stanley 6. We'll be back. With 1 minute and 43 seconds left in the second quarter, South Stanley is on the board and caught a very fortunate break on that tip. And it's 21-6. Now kickoff taken at the 10-yard line. It's Malik Jackson. Jackson runs into his own blocker. Oh, and gets hit from behind. And a penalty marker is going to come in. I wonder if that's going to be against Scenario Belly. I don't know. That's a good question. No, it's going to be a block in the back against West Stanley, wasn't it?
Against West, yeah.
Yep. So the return's to the 18, but the illegal block is going to... The penalties have been bad against West Stanley so far in this game. That's the sixth penalty against them. I'll mark it from about the 17 back to the 7.
Now the penalties have not affected the scoreboard, as you can see.
Low snap once again. Oh, the ball is... I thought the ball was loose for a moment there.
I think it was, but picked up by a West player. Can't get the number.
It's
no,
Jackson.
That's Malik, yeah.
Down at the 7, and I believe South may have just called a timeout.
Yeah, they want to talk this over.
Well, South wants to try to pin them deep and then try to maybe force a block punt or something. We'll take a quick break and be right back. Second down and 13 now. 1 minute, 22 seconds left. West Stanley pinned deep for about the first time really in this game. Jackson off the left side. Not a whole lot of room. Maybe to the 8-yard line. South will call another timeout.
Yeah, I think South wants to make something happen here.
Well, it's third down and about... maybe 11 or 12.
That's the second time out that Stanley has taken.
So while we have a second here, Brian, let's take a quick look at some of our stats from Yon Computer.
Shirley.
No, it's not named Shirley, but I appreciate you trying to name it. It's not named Shirley.
And stop calling me Shirley.
Yes. Malik Jackson so far, 12 carries, 98 yards, 2 touchdowns, averaging 8.2 yards a carry. As a team, Wes Stanley, 16 carries, 110 yards on the ground. Through the air, pretty good so far. Boone is 7 of 11 for 82 yards and a touchdown.
Very respectable.
And Taylor Rowe has that 1 9-yard completion as well. So as a team, 8 of 12 for 91 yards and a touchdown. Justin Bauckham is the leading receiver, two receptions, 33 yards. On the other side, Jawan Morris has 15 yards on just six carries. And at number 31, Michael Pressler, 3 carries, 9 yards, but the net yardage lost on sacks. South Stanley has negative 3 net yards in this first half. Jackson off the right side this time, trying to find some room, and does, 15, and down to the 22. And he's got the first down. That last effort just got it. And that's an important gain, if nothing else, Brian.
Oh, yeah, to stop Stanley from getting the ball back.
Exactly, and they can move the clock, and they don't even have to be in that particularly much of a hurry.
Well, they can take their sweet time right now.
To run out the rest of this clock if they so choose. 1 minute left, as you can see up in the upper part of our screen. It's nice to have that out there. Now, there's a football that just ran onto the field. You can't see it. It's about 40 yards off. One of the coaches, maybe Tate Osborne, going over there to get it. Now this pass is complete. And the ball is knocked loose, and it's still loose. And South picks it up at the 45. It's McKinney, 35, 30, 25, and down to the 20-yard line.
And South Stanley's back in this.
And South has another chance to score with 30 seconds left and one timeout.
I think it was down. They need to add about 3 seconds to the clock.
Did you see who caught the ball? It was Sturdivant, I believe.
I believe so.
So Sturdivant got out to about the 46-yard line, but then the ball came loose. He got knocked out. And Tavian McKinney scooped it up and took the ball down to the 23-yard line.
Here's an opportunity for
So the Bulls take their final timeout. That's sort of a waste of a timeout. They cannot stop the clock, and we're going to take a quick break, and we'll be right back. So South Stanley with a golden opportunity here at the 23, first and 10 of West Stanley, 30 seconds left. Going to go play action. Horton's got time to throw. He throws it over the middle, incomplete. I'm not really sure where he was trying to throw that football.
You got me, Charles.
Shankle Dry was about 15 yards away, and I think it might have been Tavian McKinney. And if he'd have waited another half second, McKinney would have been there. But instead, it falls incomplete, and it'll bring up second down. Clock stopped now with 24 seconds left. But the key is calling that timeout didn't give them a chance now. They can't stop the clock for a sack or anything else.
So again, get on the line real quick.
Now Horton in there throws this one-on-one situation. Is picked off at the 3. Picked off. It's going to be run out of bounds by. You want to say it or should I?
Was that Malik?
That's Malik Jackson. And he immediately goes down to the ground. I don't know if he's having a cramp or something, but the second he went up off the field, he went down immediately.
He's still down, Charles.
And he is still down. I'll have to check it a minute and see what happened there.
Could be a cramp, I think. Looks like they're trying to stretch him out here.
So he takes the ball back out to the about 18-yard line. And now Wes Stanley could just take a knee and go to the locker room if they so choose.
Oh, look at the grimace on Malik's face.
Well, he looks like he's in a lot of pain. Let's see what West Stanley will do. 14 and a half seconds left, and it looks like they're going to just take a knee here. And that's exactly what they do. And that's going to bring the end of our first half. We have reached halftime here at West Stanley Stadium. With a score, West Stanley 21, South Stanley 6. This is Stanley County Monday Night Football. It's always better to unmute your microphone before you try to talk. Back here at Stanley County, Monday Night Football, about ready to start the third quarter. 21-6 in favor of West Stanley over South. South had negative 3 yards rushing in the first half. Tremendous defensive effort by West. First downs, West Stanley with 10, excuse me, South Stanley with 2. Net yards rushing, West Stanley 124. Net yards rushing, minus 3 for South. South has 82 yards passing on that one pass, 114 yards passing for West Stanley. Total net yards, 238 to 79 in favor of West. Here's a telling stat, though. 7 penalties, 61 yards on West Stanley. South Stanley, no penalties for no yards.
That's amazing. You'd think it'd be the other way around with the stats.
But West Stanley has dominated the time of possession, 14 minutes and 28 seconds.
And you were commenting on their defense.
Their defense has been tremendous.
Have to give props to the defensive coordinator.
Green puts his foot into it. This is going to be a touchback. He practically kicked it through the uprights. It actually hit. It was so accurate and straight, it actually hit the West Stanley padding that's on the bottom of that upright.
Incredible leg. I mean, we're going to be seeing a lot of this kid this year.
Yeah. And once again, it's such an advantage to be able to set your defense at the 20-yard line and set the other team's offense at the 20. So let's see what kind of adjustment South Stanley has made in the second half. Split back set this time with a back behind him as well, almost sort of a wishbone-y look. Oh, fumble on the play. Ball is still loose. I think South fell on at number 57. Cody Carpenter.
Yeah.
Really never got a handle on the football.
Well, that's not exactly the way they wanted to start out.
And a loss of, 4 yards brings up second down and 14. Again, South Stanley has just not been able to get much going on the ground. This time straight ahead is number 1. That's Juwan Morris again.
I think Morris picked up about 4 yards.
So got most of that loss back. And now it'll bring up third down and 10. Actually, they'll give him a gain to the 21.
It's obvious they're going to probably try to go to the air.
I formation. With 2 in the backfield, Horton in trouble once again, and he goes down at the 15 by Connor Edwards, and a nice display of sportsmanship by Connor picking him up off the deck.
You always like to see that.
Loss is back to the 16, and it'll bring another punting situation. The problem is the alignment that they were using there, Brian, with 3 wide receivers and 2 in the backfield, left only 5 on the line, and it just wasn't a lot of people, and they just brought pressure, and just Horton has no time to throw. Carpenter will punt it again. a low kick finally does get it picked up off the ground. It's another short kick. It's going to take a better roll this time for South down to the 47. And Tavian was trying to usher it, just give it a little another half yard, maybe.
Kind of telepathically make it go the other way.
Do a little Sheldon Cooper there with the force and just use the force and just move it over.
If only that would work.
Yes. So it rolls dead at the 46-yard line of South Stanley. And once again, West Stanley has just dominated field position in this game as much as any other statistic.
Yeah, all night long. Yeah, 9:52 to go in the third quarter. 21-6, favor of West Stanley.
Two wide receivers this time. Rowe to the far side, and 24 is Balcom to the near side. Oh, fumble on the snap, and Christian Boone falls on it, loses a yard. We've seen a lot of that tonight, actually, from both people, and both sides. And you kind of expect that first game of the season, the jitters, the humidity, the cramps, you know, things like that.
Some all things work, all like, some things work, don't.
Some things don't, yeah.
We all have our problems. We've had our problems up here.
Second and 11 now. Clock running, 9:21 left. A little confusion on the line. But West Stanley, because they had plenty of time to fix it. Jackson to the near side, got a nice lead blocked in front of him. McKinney gets off that block, makes the tackle of the 37. It's going to bring up third and short.
If all that fails, give it to Malik.
Well, you know, I think it looks like Malik has gotten more comfortable as this game has progressed.
Third down and two.
He really is, he looks more comfortable. His first few runs were maybe, and obviously first game of the season, everybody is really hyped up, and sometimes you can come out a little tentative even because of that. Sets up a short third down though. Third down and a long two, maybe three.
Let's see. Malik.
Tight ends in this time, and Jackson will go straight up the middle. He hits the 35. It gets drugged backwards. A nice play by 31, Michael Pressler. But I think he's got the first down.
Yeah, I think his forward motion got him that first down.
Yeah, they'll mark it at 34, and that is a first down.
First down.
A little late substitution here. Joseph Izaguirre will come in for Balcom. Balcom had the nice catch earlier. Had a couple of catches in this game. Now Jackson tries to go right in the middle and went right in the teeth of the defense. Still running. Look at the power.
He was bottled up and he still got out. There's no stopping this.
He drug
this
Yarborough and Z. Bailey, drug them to the 23 for another first down. And now Jackson is at 16 carries, 137 yards. Having a solid, solid night.
Oh, yeah, Mr. Jackson's having this. Very, very good night.
West Stanley looking very comfortable. Starting to really ease into their offense. Now Jackson, again, we fumble the football, and just as you say that, South Stanley recovers. Picked up by Brian Schenkel dry.
What a break for South Stanley.
I think he got it stripped right out from him. Yeah, he was hit right in the backfield, and the ball just came flying out.
I wasn't sure, but I think he did get it stripped out of his hands.
So with 7 minutes and 24 seconds, sorry, Brian, with 7:24 left, South Stanley gets their second chance on offense in the second half, but has just got to find some way to move the football. And it's not going to be on that play. He was tripped low by number 40, Drew Kidd, with a great play.
Coming up quick there to make the stop. That's number 40, Drew Kidd. They the initial lift up. Number one, Jawan Morris.
A loss of a yard. It brings up second down and 11.
They just can't get anything going on the ground.
Three wide receivers to the far side of the field. Now Tavian is going to line up in the H-back position. You might see a quick screen here to the outside. Now they're going to sweep it this time to Morris, and Morris tries to get around the corner, gets a few yards on the angle, but going to be down to the 29. He gets about five. Connor Edwards was in the tackle, and he's been everywhere in this game. Going to bring up third down now at about six. Clock is still running, 6:25 now. Clock has stopped because he went out of bounds. 6:25 left third quarter, 21-6. Bulls trail the Colts. Four wide receivers this time. Going to be a little play action. Rolls out to his right. Can't set himself, and he's going to get tripped again and sacked again.
What is it, about four sacks on Horton?
And it's Drew Kidd on the sack this time. And yeah, that is about the fourth sack of the game. That's a 10-yard loss in another punting situation. And the stats for South Stanley are just, they get a little something going, but then they're just cannot. Right now, pass protection may be the biggest struggle that they're having.
We're just giving Horton enough time to do anything.
Boy, West Stanley had a real chance to block that one. Ball's going to roll dead at the 48. Three players got through, and I think they didn't realize how easily they got through, because suddenly they look back like, what are we? Oh, punt, right, block, you know. So we change possession once again, and now 5 minutes, 30 seconds left in the third quarter. Still 21-6 Colts. Another two-back set this time. Gonna fake to Jackson. Flag is down. It's a pretty pass, and it's complete to Rao. And Rao makes a nice move. Almost did get away, but he'll be down at the 33, but I don't think any of it is going to count.
Yeah, it's gonna be coming back.
I believe that the whole thing is coming back, but we'll wait for the decision of our official.
Who does have the last word on this?
An illegal formation against West. So they'll mark it from the original line of scrimmage, which was the South 47. And they'll mark it to the West 48.
Clock stop with 5:17 to go in the third quarter.
First and 15 now, three wide receivers. Look at the pass once again. Puts it, is looking for everything, looking for Nate Taylor, and it is picked off. Jawan Morris picks it off at the 12. Got right in front of Nate Taylor.
Oh, fumble and a pick in the last two possessions.
Well, that's one of those situations where the pass works like a punt. It pins the Bulls deep. Not necessarily what you want to do.
Exactly.
Ball was maybe just a little underthrown. And that's one of those times that you hope your wide receiver, even if he commits a pass interference call, doesn't allow the ball to change hands. but
I don't think
Nate had too much momentum to do that. Now looking over the middle, it's tipped up, and it is picked off by number three, I believe. That might have been Cameron Brown. So dueling turnovers.
Number three, Cameron Brown in the right place at the right time brings it in.
Yeah, it puts Wes Stanley in great position here.
Wes Stanley ball about the 16-yard line.
So we change hand possession once again. Few turnovers in this third quarter. Now Wes Stanley is set up even better position in the red, starting in the red zone at the 16. They'll give to Jackson. Jackson gets away from one tackler, trying to make some moves. 10, 5, got a great block in front of him. He's in, touchdown, Wes Stanley Colts. He just kept following his blockers, and he had great blocking downfield in front of him, and he might have run right off camera. I believe he may have, but he just kept staying on that sideline, and he's in for his third touchdown of the game.
Untouched.
He just had a convoy in front of him. Logan Green now for the point after. But first, we've got penalty markers down.
That's a false start. Now, West. So let's do that again.
Co-creators had the push-up board down there, am I correct? For the green band, the push-up board ready to go.
Well, the way Green's been kicking here lately, another 5 yards not going to make that much of a difference to him.
Not particularly, but that's just the, again, you know, little penalties like that may not hurt you tonight, but it's something that you want to work on for the remainder of the season. So with 4:50 left, third quarter, it's West Stanley 28, South Stanley 6. We'll be back on Stanley County Monday Night Football. Malik Jackson with his third touchdown of the game, and West Stanley now leads 28-6. Logan Green, kickoff will go into the end zone, and another touchback. It's an automatic touchback whenever it goes in the end zone now. So I would say so far, Wes Stanley has shown some flashes of real strength in this game. You know, penalties are something that you sometimes, you know, can expect from early in the season, and it's just little things that you need to work on, like getting you know, people into the game correctly and things like that. High snap this time. Oh, it's a reverse. And he's got some room to run. It's Eli Blake. He's got plenty of room. 30, 35, makes a move, 40. And down at the 45 and caught from behind.
Just got tripped up.
By Jaquan Ingram. What a clever play and a great call. And it's a 25-yard gain and a first down for South Stanley.
That's the shot in the arm they needed.
South getting their signals, running four wide from the pistol set. Horton back to throw again, got pressure, but he gets it across the middle and it is incomplete. It was behind Dallas Starnes.
Oh, what a bullet.
It was in double coverage too, but he actually found a way. That ball actually found its way through.
Yeah,
it just was a little it was just a little behind him. With that run, South Stanley now in the positive in rushing yards with 12, and they have 82 passing yards on one of nine passing, of course, that 82-yard touchdown. Horton out of the far side, incomplete again behind his receiver this time, and it was again Dallas Starnes. And it'll bring up third down.
Sounds like a football name, yeah. Dallas Starnes.
Clock stop now, 4:05 left in the third quarter. 28-6 in favor of West Stanley. South facing third and 10 now. Play clock was running a little short. Throws over the middle this time, looking for Eli Blake, and it's incomplete. A little contact there. South fans requesting that a flag be thrown. None was forthcoming. And it'll bring up fourth down. And it looks like South is just going to go for it.
I don't blame him at this point in the game.
The punt's only going to give you 20 to 30 yards, and right now time is more of your enemy, and it's good to give your offense a chance. They're going to blitz straight up the middle. Horton trying to find some room to the outside. He goes down again in another sack. And this time, I think it's the big fella. That's 58, Adam Slaughter.
Slaughter.
They got him at the 43. Appropriate name. So 3 minutes and 50 seconds left. West Stanley with another chance here to put more points on the board.
As we see the Colt crazies going crazy here.
Well, they were doing all those push-ups, and I'll tell you what. I don't know that seven push-ups I could do seven push-ups, let alone 28, which we saw earlier. They have a good support system here, though, and a good student section, a good supportive. The Colt crazies now dry, almost with a sack. Looking over the middle, overthrows everybody basically, and it brings up second down. So Boone now 9 of 15 for 106 yards, one touchdown, one interception. Clock stopped with 3:42 left to go. South with eight in the box to try to stop Malik Jackson. Tries to bounce to the outside, and this time he's going to get wrapped up.
Might have picked up a yard.
And now he's coming out of the game with maybe another cramp. Seven and 52 got Nathan Forrest and Noah Carpenter. But more importantly for West.
Yeah, he's in pain. He's been having trouble with cramps.
Third and 10 now. He only got back to the original line of scrimmage and no more.
Clock continues to run. 2:55 left in the third.
Three wide receivers this time. Boone looking to throw. Looking incomplete. It was kind of looking for Taylen Rao, and he and Jawan Morris are having a little
discussion,
exchange of pleasantries, greetings of, you know, how was your off season,
yeah,
that sort of thing.
Summer,
how was your summer vacation?
And,
yeah. And it'll bring up fourth down. That ball really not catchable. And we do have a penalty flag down. And I did not see where that flag came in. They're backing West Stanley up. Holding.
Against West Stanley.
And they're going to take the penalty. Which will mark the ball back. to the Wes Stanley 39. Third and 28 now. Field position still as important as anything. South trying to save or get as much real estate as they can. Four wide receivers this time on third and about 28. They got to get to the South Stanley 32. A little pressure from Dry on the outside. And he's got Boone this time at the 34.
Boone brought down the backfield at 15. Brian Shackle Dry.
So the first sack of the game for South Stanley. A loss of 4 yards and another punting situation for Logan Green and the Colts. Looks like Zenario Bailey going to be back deep to try to return this punt. We'll see how much pressure South brings.
As he backs up because he knows Green can really boot this.
Snaps a little high, just does get it off. Still a nice kick, but a very returnable one.
Green gets it away.
Zenario must have called a fair catch at the 33.
Spot the ball to the 32-yard line.
So we change possession once again with a minute and 50 seconds left. And South Stanley looking at 70-plus yards in front of them, or 67, rather. My math skills are still on summer vacation, apparently. First and 10 now, 1:50 left. South trailing West Stanley 28-6. Doing a little better with their passing game just in the terms of just getting the ball out of there. And that one's complete to Dallas Starnes. Brian, I think they decided that they just needed to try to go with a short passing game because West Stanley was getting far too much pressure on Horton.
Oh, they've been giving him fits all night.
Only rushing four this time. Hit as he threw the football is incomplete. He took a wallop. And gets picked up. Nice sportsmanship there. Number 55, Kyle Pennington. Knocked him down, but then, of course, picked him up.
The freshman number 55 to West Stanley coming in, Kyle Pennington.
They bring up a third down and 5 now with the ball sitting at the 37 of the Colts, 1:12 left, third quarter.
Got to be careful. The Colts are going to probably bring the heat right now.
Doesn't look like it, actually. They're only rushing four. They're dropping 7 into coverage. Swings it out, and it's incomplete. Was looking for Jawan Morris. That was almost not a forward pass, and Wes Stanley was very on the ball trying to cover that ball just in case. But it will go as an incomplete pass and bring up fourth down.
And they choose to punt.
Clock stopped now with a minute 4 left. Carpenter ready to punt this one away. And is Aguirre standing at about the 35. And before the snap, we have penalty markers down. Or maybe a timeout.
Timeout called on the field.
West Stanley calls timeout. We'll take one as well. 1:02 left, third quarter. West Stanley 28, South Stanley 6. We're back on Stanley County Monday Night Football. Here's the punt. A low one. Izaguirre is just going to run away from it as it takes a huge stop, drop, bounce, and roll down to the 16-yard line. A big punt that time by Carpenter. Clock stopped now with 49.8 seconds left.
I'd say player of the game for South Stanley, if it were, would be Carpenter probably.
Well, right now, or even I would give Jawan Morris the nod just because of the touchdown.
Well, true.
But really, it's not about a player of the game for them necessarily. They've just, they're trying to, you can see like what Coach Froge was saying, they're just trying to see what works and what doesn't. Right now, Malik Jackson, though, is having a terrific game. He's not in, though.
Yeah, having trouble with those cramps.
It's going to be number three this time, Cameron Brown. And Brown hits the hole hard, but he's actually going to, he might even lose a yard, actually.
Down 35 seconds here in the third.
They're going to give him a loss of a yard. It brings up second and 11.
And they're taking their sweet time here. They just want to run that clock out.
I think that they could actually run the rest of the clock out in the third quarter if they wanted to. Now they're going to try to run a play. At least line up to run a play.
That'll do it.
So we've reached the end of three quarters of play here at West Stanley High School with a score, West Stanley 28, South Stanley 6. We'll be back on Stanley County Monday Night Football. We're back on Stanley County Monday Night Football. Now we have whistles, and did that play ever happen? I'm really not 100% sure. I don't know that they whistled the ball ready for play. I personally was looking down at my computer trying to figure out what I was doing, and I think we're going to get what we call a do-over.
Yeah.
I think we're going to start.
So let's start this thing over.
So we'll start it over and reset the clock to 12, possibly, or just count 3 seconds and let it go.
Yeah. We got it at 11:57.
We're going to be back here next week on Stanley County Monday Night Football for a very interesting matchup and what will be a very emotional night as West Montgomery comes to town to play West Stanley, and it's going to be Go Orange night, and we'll tell you more about that in just a second. Little pass to the near side, complete to Rao, gets by one defender, has a block in front of him. 20, flag is down, and he's still on his feet and still on drug down at the 35-yard line.
Oh, what an effort.
Jake Green rode him for about 10 yards. There's two penalty flags down. So let's see. There are two flags down. Let's see if we got a couple
upsetting
of penalties here. I really couldn't tell you, but it was a 20-yard gain. But let's see what the penalties are. If the penalty's offset, then the play never happened. Illegal block in the back against West Stanley.
So I'll pin West Stanley pretty deep.
This will be almost a half the distance to the goal kind of penalty. Was the penalty? This is another one of those instances where we've seen, Brian, how the point of where the penalty happens affects the game, affects things so much more. That penalty happened at the 10 and was marked to the 5 or 6-ish. So it sets up, you know, second down and 21. It was going to be 10 yards either way, I guess, but in this case,
you know, half the distance.
It was half the 10, you know, it was already 5 yards before they even started to mark the penalty. They'll give to Izaguirre. Izaguirre up the middle, got some great moves, still on his feet. 20, 25, 30, 35, 40, and down to the 44-yard line.
Incredible run.
Number 22, Joseph Izaguirre.
He said Izaguirre. I've always said Izaguirre. I'm going to have to find
Izaguirre.
I'm going to find out. Potato, potato. Let's call the whole thing off, but I'll find out. But Joseph.
Izaguirre is what
I've always said Izaguirre, but I'm not sure about that. Nonetheless, the gain is out to the, well, make it the 45-yard line. About a 40-yard gain that time for Joseph Izaguirre.
Now they got some room to work.
Clock running now, under 11 minutes, 19 seconds left in this fourth and final quarter. West Stanley leading 28-6, and they can.
I'm assuming they're wanting this clock just to run out.
They could milk this clock for all it's worth now if they wanted to. Pass to the near side, complete to Rowe, 45-50. Look at the speed of Taylen Rowe. He's still on his feet, tightroping the sideline and out of bounds at the 7.
Oh, what a tap dance.
I do not know how he kept his feet in bounds around the 20 or 30. And look at his head coach that was cheering so much. I believe he just pump-fisted his headset right off of his head.
That's what you want to see, the excitement.
Now, Cody Carpenter saved a touchdown. They're going to mark him out at the South 11. Little low snap this time. They'll give it to Rao again. And this time knocked down about the 6. That time tackled by Michael Pressler. That was a 44-yard gain that time. And then that little pass gained about 3 yards, make it 4. Actually, it's inside the, so it's inside the box, so it's first and goal. It was actually at the 10-yard line, so a gain of 4 that time brings up 2nd and 6. Late, the ball is loose. A late try to handoff, and I don't know who recovered that. White
Noah
ball.
Carpenter.
I just heard somebody say
Noah
it. Yep, number 7.
Yep.
It was Noah Carpenter. Good call.
Yep. He was right on top of it. Good job.
That exchange just never happened. And once again.
You know, South Stanley pinned deep. I don't know how really good this is for them.
No, but once again, South Stanley's defense, you know, comes up with the turnover. And West Stanley.
But they've manhandled.
West Stanley has been in the red zone 5 or 6 times, but they only have about a couple of scores have come out of it. High snap this time, and the ball is still loose, and that's going to be a safety. That's a safety.
Yeah.
They're waiting just to make sure that it's a South Stanley person on the bottom. And it's a safety. It was a bad snap. Went over Maxton Horton's head. Dallas Starnes tried to fall on it, so he saved him some points at least by not letting West recover it for a touchdown. But it will go as a safety. And we'll take a break and be right back. 10:03 left in the fourth quarter. West Stanley now 30, South Stanley 6. We're back on Stanley County Monday Night Football. 30-6, here's the free kick. It's straight up in the air. And a fair catch called for by number 81, Dennis Rogers.
It's like right about on the 45. 44.
That's the South 44. And once again, West Stanley sets up shop offensively. Starting on South Stanley's side of the field. Just for curiosity's sake, I'm looking at the drive chart. The average starting field position in this game for South Stanley is their own 25. West Stanley's average starting position is the South Stanley 49.
That spells disaster for South.
That's you're playing behind the eight ball, as it were, almost immediately. Three wide receivers this time, 1st and 10 from the 45 of South Stanley. Going to give to Cameron Brown. Brown hits the line hard and hits Nathan Forrest as well. Doesn't move much further than that. Maybe a yard, bring up 2nd and 9.
And both South and West have their full complements of timeouts.
You're asking me tough questions. You realize it's all I can do to be over here to keep the stats, announce, keep my Twitter feed going, drink some water, and keep my sanity.
And keep me straight.
I gave up long ago on that. Second and nine thanks. Now. You're welcome. Second and nine now. I think somebody's called a timeout, but I can't remember who. Brown this time hits the linebacker, gets him to the linebacker level, down about the 38, a gain of about six. Bring up third and short. Bring up third down and about three. I think Malik Jackson's night is done. I see him over by the big industrial-sized fan on the sideline with his helmet off. He's had some problems with cramping in his legs, obviously. He'll finish with 19 carries, 151 yards, and three touchdowns. As a team, West Stanley has 199 yards on 31 carries. A bad snap this time. Boone does a great job of making a play out of it and actually is very close to a first down and may have gotten it.
I think he may have gotten it.
I don't know if that was a design draw or not.
I don't think so, but he picked up the first down. The sticks are moving.
He improvised very nicely there. And they'll mark it at the 33. Clock continuing to run now, 8:10 left in the fourth quarter. I was telling you earlier that this has been sort of a tough summer for people in Stanley County, especially in the sports arena, because of the passing of a couple of very popular local coaches. Round this time off the right side, we get down to about the 30. So give him three and bring up second down at seven. But the coach in particular that I'm referring to is Ben Meisenheimer, who was a JV basketball coach for years at West Stanley and was coaching the varsity basketball and baseball over at West Montgomery. And very, very suddenly he passed away this summer. So both West Montgomery, West Montgomery's coming to West Stanley next week, and both teams are going to have what they call Go Orange Night. They're going to have a 50-50 draw to help fund a scholarship fund in his memory. And there are several other activities that Liz Honeycutt was telling me about. That pass just bounces over and it's going to bring up third down and seven.
Yeah, it stops the clock with 7 minutes to go in this game.
Bring up third down.
So it's going to be nice next week. It's not, things like that are always very, very sad. And Ben, I knew Ben through the coaching circles, of course, and he's just a wonderful, wonderful person. And it's really nice to see both West Montgomery and West Stanley kind of coming together. It'll be nice to see them come together next week and sort of celebrate Ben's life.
Because, they're rivalries and everything, but we're all the sports family, right?
Oh, another fumble. The ball is still loose. Eight different people had a shot at it.
Let's see who's at the bottom of the pile here.
It's going to be recovered by West Stanley.
I think it's number 76.
At the 36, Tanner Pennington falls on it. And it's going to bring up fourth down. But just to finish the point, we'll be here next week for Monday Night Football, and it'll be nice to see those two communities come together and honor somebody that was really a nice person, and a good person in our sports business and teaching business and coaching business. And
so that's great to see people coming together, everybody coming together for a cause like that.
So it looks like West is going to go for it on fourth down. The slot receiver is not even covered right now. They're just, I don't know if they're going to run the football. A punt would do no good, and really.
They're just milking the clock.
I think they're just milking
here.
The clock for all it's worth. And as a matter of fact, they may call timeout or take a delay of game and give them five more yards to punt, and that's exactly what they're going to do.
Flag down there. It's going to be a delay of game against West Stanley. We're marking back five. Look up and around. Living Green is taking the field.
Help me. Just out of curiosity, I wanted to see the penalties still. That's 12 penalties for 105 yards. South Stanley still no penalties in this game.
No penalties.
Now, obviously, that you know they have had a tough time moving the football. They've had turnovers. But it's little. There are things like that that you can, you know.
It's a positive.
A positive that you can take out of the game. Another beautiful, high, spiraling punt. It's going to roll out of bounds. Look at this. You couldn't have thrown that. You couldn't have rolled it like a bowling ball out there any better.
Look at that.
Right at the three-yard line.
Three-yard line. I'm telling you. There's something special about that kid.
And what an advantage that gives you.
Absolutely. Look at this.
Unbelievable.
Backed him up on the three-yard line.
With 5 minutes and 53 seconds left. South Stanley just trying to find some positive yards. Nice run here by Jawan Morris. He breaks free and he could be gone. Look at this. It's a foot race. 40, 30, 20. Nate Taylor is trying to get close to him. He's getting a little close, but he will not get there. Touchdown, South Stanley, Rowdy Rebel Bulls. That's a 97-yard touchdown run.
Wow.
There are no flags on the field.
Yeah, he slowed up right at the end. He's got to be careful about doing that.
Well,
you don't know who's going to come
I don't know if
it.
He slowed up because I don't know if he slowed up intentionally, you know,
well,
in another reason other than
he
might have been just
yards,
exhausted.
Yeah, true. If I tried to run 100 yards at
if I tried
full
to run 100
speed,
feet, I'd be exhausted. Yeah. But so that makes it 30-12. And it looks like South's going to go for two. And they still... There's an outside chance. You know, it was three scores. It was a 24-point game with that safety. So they would need three touchdowns and 3 2-point conversions, and they just got the first one. You never know.
Never know.
That's why they play 48 minutes.
Stranger things have happened.
Three back set this time. Turned around, did not have the oh, good night of the living. What a hit. Stop short is saying it mildly. Jawan Morris just got blasted by Jaquan Ingram, the freshman. What a hit. The extra point attempt is no good. We'll take a break with 5:33 left in the fourth quarter. West Stanley 30, South Stanley 12. We're back on Stanley County Monday Night Football. 5:33 left in the game. West Stanley 30, South Stanley 12. Jawan Morris with a 97-yard touchdown run just out of nowhere. Oh, and their little trickery. They're going for the onside kick and touched it. Wait, if they'd have actually just tried to let that roll a little bit, they may have.
Would have went to 10 yards.
It may have gone to 10 yards, but instead Morris grabbed it a little too early. And now we have a discussion, and I'm not sure exactly what we have. Got to let it go 10 yards before you can touch it, obviously.
Hey, folks, next week we are going to have another home game next week. We got all the home games, we got a special night next week.
So West Stanley, what's going to happen is it'll just be West Stanley football at the 47.
We'll let the student body know the meeting is at this week, but we need everybody Friday night when you come to the West Stanley game, you want to wear it some orange, okay?
So it's orange. It's go orange. It's like I was telling you about. We're just listening to the PA announcer telling us about it. You know, I've got to find some orange myself. I don't know that I own any orange.
I have an orange shirt that I will wear.
Yeah.
So the Colts leading 30-12 here. 5:32 left in this game. And before the snap, we may have a timeout. And West Stanley has called timeout. We'll take one as well. 5:32 left, fourth quarter. West Stanley comfortably ahead, 30-12. We're back on Stanley County Monday Night Football. Charles Curcio from the Stanley News and Press alongside Mr. Brian Carter of Carter Video Services. Brown now straight up the middle. 45 and down around the 43.
He's over the 45 and 43-yard line. Gain of 4, second down and 6.
Something else, Brian, that we need to mention about tonight's result is that it ends an 8-game losing streak, and frankly, it ends a 9-game on the field losing streak. Their third game of the season, they played Albemarle and lost 21-7, but of course, that was one of the 7 games that Albemarle forfeited last year. So this really is a 9-game on the field losing streak that West Stanley had, 8 officially, that will end tonight with this if this score continues to stay the way it is.
Good way to start the season.
Taking as much time off the play clock as they can. Brown again this time. Gotten some good moves behind his blockers. Finally gets wrestled down by about four different South Stanley players. I'll tell you one thing. You cannot fault South Stanley defensively in the sense of how they have gotten to the football. They have been very aggressive getting to the football in this game. Brings up third down and 3. And obviously, you know, football really is a numbers game, and when you have only 24, 25 or so players, you know, it's very difficult to, you know, most of you guys are going to have to play both ways, and that's why conditioning is so important, as what Coach Froge told us earlier in the pregame.
Well, it seems like they're very well conditioned. I mean, they're really making the most of what they have.
Still playing very hard. Another slow snap this time. Brown off the right side. Still on his feet, and he's got a first down at the 35.
David Brown takes it ahead. He's over the 35, down to about the 33-yard line.
So the clock will stop at 3:35 to move the chains, but West Stanley comfortably ahead in this game. Like I said, looking ahead next week, we will be back here for West Montgomery and West Stanley. South Stanley next week will be off. And the Colts just called another timeout.
So I guess we'll take
one. We'll take
one
as well. 3:06 left, fourth quarter. We're back on Stanley County Monday Night Football. Charles Curcio, Stanley News and Press. Don't forget to see your Sunday Stanley News and Press to see all about this particular game and see Tuesday's News and Press for more coverage on the other two Stanley games this week, which is Thomasville and Albemarle. Thomasville won tonight 31-22 over Albemarle, and of course North Stanley was at Bunker Hill. Bunker Hill, of course, located between Conover and Statesville. Yes, I had to look it up on Google Maps because I really didn't know where it was. But
How far away is that?
Statesville's at least an hour and probably another 20 minutes, 30 minutes down the, maybe not that long, down the interstate, down I-40. So, well, a long drive. Brown again getting the workload right now.
Clock continues to run. We got 2:10 left.
Reese Weicker with a tackle that time. And now South Stanley calls a timeout. Let's take a look at some stats while we have a few seconds here. South Stanley, 22 carries on the ground, 97 yards. Actually, Juwan Morris, obviously, with 90, when you have a 97-yard attempt for a touchdown, that makes your numbers pretty good. 10 carries, 121 yards. But as a team, 22 carries, 97 yards for South Stanley. Maxton Horton, 2 of 14, odd stats, 2 of 14 for 87 yards and 2 interceptions. It's very odd.
Strange.
You know, usually when you see 2 of 14, you don't see that many yards, but obviously he had that one 82-yard pass for the touchdown. There's also, he also had one touchdown. And that was to Juwan Morris.
We're back to the action here.
West Stanley has 39 carries, 216 yards. Oh, I think did the ball maybe come out again?
I think he held on to it. Yeah, he held on to it.
Just kept getting pushed backwards, but he actually is going to lose about 3 yards on that run.
Yeah, Cameron Brown. They were trying to strip it out of his hands, but he held on to it.
Actually give him a 4-yard loss. Clock is stopped with a minute 58. Do we have another timeout? I think we may have had another timeout call.
As we hear the West Stanley band.
40 carries for West Stanley, 212 yards. Malik Jackson, again, we said 19 carries, 151 yards, and 3 touchdowns. Christian Boone, 11 of 18 through the air for 155 yards, 1 touchdown, 1 interception. Taylen Rowe, 7 catches tonight for 70 yards.
Do you have any favorites for player of the game?
Oh, I think player of the game might be pretty obvious. Green now with another punt. Nobody back to return it. This one will go into the end zone, and we'll come back out to the 20.
Put it out on the 20-yard line.
I think it's pretty clear who our player of the game is tonight when you have 3 touchdowns on the ground.
Oh, yeah.
Really hard to give it to anyone else but Malik.
Folks, if you've been watching
Christian
this game,
Boone, I mean, the argument could be made for Christian Boone as well. He had a pretty solid night with the 1 touchdown pass as well.
And overall, a great team effort by the Colts.
Good, very good blocking up front for him. Maxton Horton barks out the signals now on 1st and 10 from the 20. Gets the snap. Wings one to the far side of the field, looking for Brian Schenkel. Trying, he's got him at the 47.
Oh, nice pass. As they hurry up to the line.
It's very funny, and I say funny as in unusual. South Stanley has all their yards on about 3 or 4 plays. They've had a 20-yard pass, a 20-yard pass, a 97-yard run, an 82-yard pass. The rest of their attempts have all been really negligible.
Yeah, they need to be more consistent on the ground.
Horton now trying to throw again and looking, and this one's going to be picked off at the 25. And it's Izaguirre with the interception.
Well, this could just about wrap it up. With a minute 22.
Oh, this should definitely, they'll take it to the 46-yard line, and this should be all with a minute 22 left. A couple of knees in this game should be on ice for West Stanley. I get confused sometimes. I've been saying North and Outball and everybody else tonight. Whew. I'm still on summer vacation, obviously. Again, next week, we'll be right back here at Red Cross to watch the West Stanley Colts host a team that many say has a terrific chance to get back and really challenge for a state championship in West Montgomery. Oh, fumble on the play. West Stanley picks it up.
Quarterback taking the knee on that one. We're going to run out the clock.
think Boone was trying to take a knee.
I think he was as well.
Yeah, below the minute mark here.
Takes another knee. One more knee and this game will be over.
Yeah, down below 20 seconds here. This should be the last play of the game, Charles.
One more knee, and that will do it. Your final score, West Stanley 30, South Stanley 12. We'll be back with the postgame show on Stanley County, Monday Night Football.
We're here on the postgame show on Stanley County Monday Night Football with our player of the week. We'll get you a t-shirt as soon as we can. Malik Jackson. Malik, let's talk a little bit first about West's ability tonight to run the football. What made it seem like just you guys were able to sort of run it at will?
Well, our line was just fantastic. They got to all their blocks. They played just great. It's all because of them.
And it just looked like the further this game went on, the more comfortable you and the offense kind of felt in this game.
Well, yeah, it was the first game, so we had to get, you know, the jitters out. But after that, we just came in, we played football, did what we practiced, and listened to coach, and everything fell in place.
Big game for you this week. Obviously, it ends an 8-game losing streak for West Stanley. How important is it to start this season with a win?
Well, it builds confidence because we worked hard in the summer, in the spring, and we was working real hard. So that goes to build a lot of confidence. So in the season, we're going to keep winning.
A tough test for you guys next week, a very talented West Montgomery team. Talk a little bit about how you keep the momentum going.
Well, we just keep working hard, keep doing what we do best, and we're just going to show up and just best team wins.
There you go. Malik Jackson, our Stanley County Monday Night Football Player of the Week. We'll be back in just a minute. Great game. We're back on Stanley County Monday Night Football with head coach Eric Mormon. Coach, let's talk a little bit first about the ground game. It seemed like they got off to a little bit of a slow start, but just started building momentum as the game continued.
Yes, sir. Like we said, I think we came out a little nervous, but our guys did come out. We finally got in the groove there, and they competed, and that's the good thing. You know, we ran the ball great, but I want to run it better. I'm not going to lie to you. I want to run it better, and we have a lot of things to clean up. We have to protect the football, but I am excited. I'm very happy with what the line did up front, but we can clean a lot of things up and get it better. So.
Well, and there was a good balance tonight, I thought, between the run and the pass. You know, Christian gave you a great effort out there as well. It just seemed like if that's something that West Stanley can do this year is balance run and the pass, that just makes you guys that much more of a dangerous team.
Yes, knowing with Malik Jackson, he's going to make a lot of plays for us. So with that, we have to be able to hit play action over the top, and that's one thing that we're going to do. We're going to try our best to run the football. And we want to be a team that throws a lot of play action. Yes, sir.
And then talk about the defense, just really stifling tonight. Got sacks, yes, on the South quarterback. Talk a little bit about your team's defensive efforts.
They play like a veteran group. We returned 11 starters. And that group, they came out, they were disciplined, they did what they were supposed to do. We gave up a couple plays there, but overall, they were disciplined and did what they were supposed to do. And I'm very excited about that group. And, you know, we'll, like that group, too. We'll clean a lot of things up, and we'll keep getting better each and every game.
How do you keep this going next week? You've got a very tough test with West Montgomery.
Well, we're excited. You know, like I said, anybody we play against, we're going to make sure we give them all. That's just something that we've been talking about over the spring and the summer with West Stanley. And with West Montgomery coming in, we got to clean up the turnovers, clean up the little mistakes on defense, and West Stanley will be here to compete. Yes, sir.
Coach, thank you very much for your time, and congratulations on your first coaching win.
Yes, sir. Thank you.
We'll be back in just a second. So West Stanley ends an 8-game losing streak with a 30-12 win tonight over South Stanley. Next week, South Stanley is off, but West Stanley will be right back here to take on the West Montgomery Warriors, and we will be here for that game as well. For my broadcast partner, Brian Carter, that's him, of Carter Video Services, I'm Charles Curcio. We'll see you in the Stanley News and Press on Sunday, and we'll see you on television right here next week.
Football is a 20th century technological struggle.
And what I seen was this whole raft of people a-setting on these two banks and looking at one another across this pretty little green cow pasture.
Football has hitting, clipping, spearing, blocking, punting, late hitting, unnecessary roughness, and personal fouls.